Hello, good afternoon. Muito boa tarde, ladies and gentlemen. Now that we are reaching the end of this great day, it's the moment to say a few words, last words, in these closing remarks. The theme of this conference was the metaphorical cycle of intellectual property, but the signature was remember the past, do in the present. And now I'm going to change the word reflect to dare for the future. And why? Because it's not possible to understand where we are today or to what we can become tomorrow if we don't understand and learn from the past. Why? Because when we speak about creativity, innovation, manifestation, it's exactly this virtuous cycle of idea, focus on how, experiment, deliver, exactly or too much similar to the butterfly life cycle that is key for the progress and evolution. And so during this day, we have more than 1,200 participants, and this is great. And we have 33 speakers who gave life and substance to this debate. Thank you all for the participation. But a second word to thank the dream team from IMPI. I think they are doing, they have done a fantastic job in the preparation of this event. And so with this background that we spoke today about intellectual property as a supporter and a brother in arms to innovators, entrepreneurs, inventors, investigators that must be seen as an engine for social and economic development with knowledge as its main strategic resource and learning as its main process. But allow me to return to the basic question of this conference. Why is intellectual and industrial property important? First, as a guarantor of fundamental rights, the core of the intellectual and industrial property is interconnected and with fundamental rights of property and ownership, encompassed in the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, and I quote, "Everyone has the right to the protection of the moral and material interest resulting from any scientific, literary, or artistic production of which he or she is the author." And this is accomplished by several ways: by the creation of restrictions, by the form of exclusive rights of commercial use, on the free dissemination of knowledge, compensating for the production of costs of these creations of the mind, and ensuring that the idea life cycle, from its conception to its implementation, is safe from undue appropriation. The second topic that I'd like to emphasize in this idea why property, intellectual property is important, because it's an economic booster. As stressed by my colleague Brilhante Dias, IP captures and ensures the competitive advantage of innovation and provides an environment for exponential economic growth. But again, we need to do more, especially in Europe. If we think that small and medium enterprises, SMEs, represent 99% of the European economic fabric, and only 9% of these economic agents protect their IP rights, we need to do something more. And especially in this pandemic moment that we are facing, the importance of IP rights must not be forgotten in the global tsunami that affects the world economy. And bearing this in mind, the European Union Intellectual Property Office, EWIPO, supported by the European Commission, created the SME Fund, promoting the registration of their intangible assets. The Portuguese SMEs answer to the first call in a very large percentage, a good sign for this recognition. And so the topics that we had today during this conference, I would like to emphasize three main ideas. The first, included in the first panel, that spoke about the importance of IP for the private, for the academic, and for the public sector, is exactly the idea of the importance of collaboration. We have good examples of how it works well when all the players interact, no matter if we are speaking about the part of the state, if we are speaking about the part of enterprises, or even for academy. I think that the future and the multiple lines of the future can be filled by a healthy, innovative, and proactive private sector, profiting of the investigation and experiments of the academic sector, and where the public sector contributes largely with public policies and as a promoter and consumer of innovation. And this is the innovation ecosystem that we intend to create together. The second panel, we heard about counterfeiting and its consequences in a world more and more digital. And it was very important, the highlights that we heard about. No matter if you are speaking about our digital footprint in this age of misinformation, or the digital counterfeiting resulting of the exponential growth of electronic commerce, and especially in the last year, we have that. The Portuguese presidency in the area of justice considers the fight against counterfeiting one of our priorities, as the Minister of Justice presented this morning. And so, in order to give stage to, and visibility to this discussion, it will be celebrated in 5 June, the World Anti-Counterfeiting Day in 2021, with the launch of EUIPO's project Authenticities in partnership with Lisbon City Council. And for this event in particular, the City of Lisbon will have the attribution of the Authentic City. This is something that we are very happy to have. But the last panel of our conference brought the topic of the global market and the protection of IP. And here I return to the metaphor. It's the moment when the butterfly opened wings and fly. Today's world, more than ever, is global. And our citizens are more and more world citizens, digital nomads, as we call it today. And that is our challenge. Openness, agility, innovation, capacity to deliver no matter where we are. This is the new reality for companies, government, and civil society. Some speak about that, about the fourth or fifth revolution. But are we prepared? Do we dare to be prepared? So, in the end, dear participants, we are speaking about us, people, European citizens, world citizens, our lives, our jobs, our businesses, our investigation, our governments, our well-being, our rights protection. Everything is interconnected. And so the cycle is closed and reopened again. But three main words, hopefully, will stay over and over again. Be sustainable, be creative, but especially be yourself. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your attention. Take care, be happy, and continue with us, because there is no better way to finish this conference than with music. Thank you. Muito obrigada.